going to install new brake rotors and pads on our 79 Trans Am. I've got a little slight vibration above 60 miles an hour, and I need to get it taken care of before heading out to the Trans Am Nationals next week. So, I've got both rotors and all the pads for the front end. Obviously, we're going to do this one side at a time. We're going to start on the bad side first. Obvious thing, lift the car up, take the wheel off. I'm going to remove the caliper. Then we're going to have to disassemble the spindle to get the new rotor on. But here we go. I will get back to you when I have the car up in the air and the wheel off. Oh, always safety first. Make sure you have your jack stand and put your tire underneath just in case it falls.
Sad thing is, this rotor actually isn't too bad of condition physically. But there is definitely a vibration somewhere in this rotor.
The surface isn't too bad. Pads are actually pretty good. But I'm going to go ahead and replace this rotor anyway. Hopefully that'll solve my vibration. I'm also going to repack the bearings while I have this out. Remove the caliper. You have two bolts here, one here, one back down here. This whole piece should slide up out of the way. Never let it hang on the brake line itself. Either string it up with a coat hanger or set it somewhere where it won't fall. Then we have to take the cap off of this. There will be a nut and a cotter pin. Should be a cotter pin behind here. And then we should be able to loosen up the spindle. Alrighty. You see I got the caliper off. I would actually say this wasn't done too long ago. Here's the pads. They're in really good shape. I'm going to actually keep these. Just because of the fact that they are in really good shape. But obviously keep them together. Now you need to knock off this center cap. I already had it started. Okay, and in the mix of all of this goop, there is a cotter pin. There she is. And the other end should be down here and here. You're going to pull that cotter pin out. You can either cut it out or do what I'm going to do, which is actually to save it, because I'm assuming this cotter pin isn't that old. This looks like it was all done recently. Anyway, so you're going to pull the cotter pin out. Alright, after you pull the cotter pin out, you'll have this castle nut. I've already started loosening. It should not be this loose. You're going to spin your castle nut off. Alright, then you're going to have a spacer in here. I'm trying to do this without getting my camera all dirty. Your spacer. That should come out next. Spacer. And then you should have your first, your outer bearing. Bearing, then you should have your spindle should be able to come off.
You have your inner bearing and your seal, which I just realized I have to go get myself a seal. So there's no way I'm going to be able to pull that one out and save it, so I'm going to have to get a bearing seal here. Wasn't thinking of that.
But that's as far as you need to disassemble any of this. Just clean up this area. This bearing seal looks pretty good. I'm going to leave as much of this grease on here as I can. But that's how you take your rotor off. When you go to put the new rotor on, you're obviously going to put your bearing in.
put your new seal in, and then slide this up on there. But I gotta run to the parts store. Alright, I had managed to get the other seal out without fucking it up, so because it is a good new seal. It also saves me a couple bucks. But assembly is virtually the same as your disassembly. Take your bearing, you pack it. Like I said, this one's pretty well packed already, so I'm just gonna slide this one in here. I'll show you how to pack bearings in another video. But, then you're gonna wanna put your seal back in. You're gonna tap that all the way around, nice and even. Don't try to crush it. Don't try to force it. I'll show you when I get back to there. All right. Once your bearing and your seal is in, you're gonna put your new hub and rotor back up on the spindle, and then I'm gonna pack the whole area with grease. All right. Well, I'm gonna show you how to pack a bearing here. This is not clean. But basically, take your grease, slap it in your hand, and the object you're trying to do is you're trying to force the grease inside that groove there so it comes out through the bearings. You can do this several ways, but you want to keep stuffing it in through until it starts pushing out the top.
Once it starts pushing out the top, and then you have the bearing packed. Takes a little bit longer with a new set of bearings, but because these have already been packed once, it doesn't take that long.
And that's basically how you pack a bearing. You need to slide the bearing longs. Okay, and that's how you pack a bearing. Then we're going to my hand a little bit here. Slide our spacer back in here. It'll only go in one way. Alright, and after your spacer, you got the castle nut. Everything in their brother is interrupting my filming here. This is why people don't film outside. This doesn't need to be tightened that much, hence the reason why you have the cotter pin. You're basically just going to tighten it enough that it starts creating a little bit of resistance on the rotor. Yes, I probably should be using a socket. Okay, I'm gonna back it off a little. No, you should have no wobble in it. Then you just put your cotter pin back in. Find a hole. So much grease on here, I can't find my hole. But anyway, you put the cotter pin back in. Everybody has their own different way of bending it so it doesn't come out. Yes, I know the cotter pin's not in. You tap your cap back on, and then you put your rotor in. Right. Now we're going to install the brake shoes. Alrighty, before you install your calipers and put it on the thing, you need to make sure that the piston is all the way down.
And to do that, I use a C-clamp. Basically, all you're going to do is clamp the C-clamp down slowly. You don't want to do it too fast because you can enter air into the system. You just use an old pad. Very slowly bring the piston all the way back down to the home position. It'll adjust itself as soon as you try the brakes for the first time. That's all there is to that. You can install your brakes again. Alright, first thing you want to do is you want to make sure you install grease or lubricant to the backside of your brake pads so they don't squeal. You don't need much. And mainly you just want it at the contact points. And normally I just paint the areas where you're going to have metal contact. You can normally see where it is because you'll see the wear on the caliper. Again, like I said, do not let this hang on the caliper itself. This is what holds the pad to the piston. Again, this is basically just to keep your brakes quiet. Inner shoe first. We've already put our grease on there. Okay. You're then going to slide your caliper onto the rotor. You're going to grease your bolts with anti-seize so they don't lock in. Take the same tool that you had to take them off, crank them back down in. Repeat for the other side. That is how you install new rotors on a 79 Trans Am. Thank you for watching Novataz Customs. Please like and subscribe for more. Thank you.